Your email inbox doesn't have to be a mess. So in this video, I'm going to show you three easy ways to clean up your Gmail. No new tools and no complicated setup, just simple steps to feel more in control and less overwhelmed. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And here I am within my sample inbox, and I've got over 400 emails here. Now, that might not even be that large of a number compared to yourself. Let me know in the comments if you have way more, maybe into the thousands of messages here within your inbox. So how can I reduce this number easily and quickly, and then keep my inbox nice and trim so I don't have to do this on a regular basis? Well, let's start with tip number one, and we're going to make use of the search bar up here at the top of the screen. Now, in this step, we are going to move the majority of our emails. We're going to pick a time frame in the past and move all of those emails to archive. Now, just as a refresher, archive is going to send those messages to your all mail folder. It is nothing to do with your spam or your trash folders. Everything that you put into archive is going to remain there, so you can search for it, you can add labels, you can do whatever you want with it, but the important thing is it's not going to be here in your inbox. So up here in the search bar, I want you to place your cursor, and I'm going to type in something very specific. We're going to start with the word older, and then we're going to select underscore older underscore than, and then we're going to hit a colon. Now, what comes next is really up to you in terms of your time frame. You could put in the number one followed by the letter Y, which of course stands for year. So if I was to hit enter now, everything older than 1 year would be presented. But you can also, of course, change that number, anything 3 years in the past. In my example, I'm actually going to change that Y to an M. I want it to show everything that is older than 1 month. I'm going to hit enter on my keyboard, and immediately it's going to show me everything that is older than a month. I can see that here by the date, the most recent one that it is showing me here. Now, you may think in order to archive all of these messages, all you need to do is select this group select, not at the individual level. We want to come up here to the top and select this and then hit archive, which is conveniently right beside that group select. But wait just a minute. We actually haven't selected everything. We have only selected the 25 emails that are displayed in front of us right now. You may recall that you get to choose what is the maximum number of messages that are shown on a given page. And in my setup, I've chosen the number 25. And it even conveniently tells me here, after I've chosen this group select, all 25 conversations on this page are selected, but next to it, we actually have a link. Select all conversations that match this search. This is exactly what we want at this stage. We want everything that is older than 1 month. So I'm going to select that option. It will give us a confirmation telling us all conversations in this search are now selected. And so now I can come up here to that archive button, and it may give you a warning, confirm bulk action. This is going to affect everything in this search. Are you sure you want to continue? I'm going to say okay. Now, depending on how many emails that you have, this may actually take some time. Down below, it says we archived some conversations. We'll do the same for any remaining conversations in a few minutes. So if you have several hundred, maybe you have several thousand emails, don't worry if it doesn't all happen immediately. It may take a few minutes, but be rest assured that it is working in the background. And in my case, it only took about 30 seconds in total. Now we're back here within my inbox, but you can see I only have 19 total messages. That's fantastic. Only 19 messages and only 12, which I have not read yet. So this is already much more manageable. But how can we keep going and make sure that we keep our inbox nice and trim so we don't have to take those bulk actions so often in the future? Well, step number two is I'm going to suggest that you send some of these messages that you don't want to deal with right now, send them to the future. Yeah, we're going to put them in some type of time machine so that we can remove them here from our inbox, but then deal with them at a more appropriate time in the future. And for that, we're going to use the snooze feature. I'm going to click on this email here as an example, and you can see within any of your emails, if you come up here to the top, we have a number of quick actions that are available to us. About the fifth one over is called snooze. So if I don't want to deal with this message right now, but I still want to come back and maybe reply or review its contents tomorrow, I can come up here and select snooze. Now it's going to give me a couple of default options: later today, tomorrow, this weekend, next week. I find that 90% of the time, one of these options is most appropriate. But if you don't find something here that is appropriate to you, you can come down to the bottom and pick a specific date and time. Now let's go back, and I'm going to actually pick one of those defaults. I'm going to say, bring this back tomorrow. And it's going to tell me specifically when it's going to bring it back, tomorrow at 8 a.m. I'm going to select that, and immediately that message is now gone here from my inbox. And tomorrow morning at 8 a.m., it will somewhat magically appear back in my inbox so I can deal with it there. Now, if you've ever made a mistake and snoozed something that you still want to deal with now, or you want to bring it back to your inbox, you can simply come over here to the left-hand side and there is a snoozed section. Here we can find that message that we just snoozed. Now, I can deal with it right here. It's going to tell me up here at the top that it's snoozed until tomorrow, but that's not going to stop me from forwarding this email or replying to this email. If I want to make it nice and simple, I could just say unsnooze and it will immediately bring it back to my inbox. But there is no limit on how many messages that you can snooze. But to make this feature even more useful, let's try and reduce the number of clicks. You don't want to have to open up every single email and then click snooze. Here within Gmail, you probably have a really good idea just by the sender, the subject line, and the preview text if you need to even open up that message. Now you could come over here and select the checkbox beside that message and even select a few if you wanted to and then snooze them at the same time. Just keep in mind, if you do group select, you'll have to snooze them to the exact same period. But there's actually a much easier way to do this. And for that, we're going to come up here to our gear icon and select See All Settings. And within the very first general tab, about the fifth one down, you can see that there's an option here called hover actions. And what we want to do is enable those hover actions. This is going to give us quick access to not only the snooze controls, but other things such as archive and delete. Now, once making any change on this screen, don't forget to scroll all the way down to the bottom and select save changes. Now, when we are returned to our inbox, here you can see as I drag my cursor down between the different messages, I've got options here on the right, including the ability to quickly snooze any of these messages without having to open them at all. So if you're not seeing these hover options here, go into your settings and be sure to turn them on. Now, the third step, which is going to help us keep our inbox nice and clean and uncluttered with older emails, is we are going to make use of another feature which is built right into Gmail. Typically, when you go to reply to a message, you are simply going to keep that message here in your inbox. So for example, here I'm going to reply to this message and I'm going to hit send. But what's going to happen next? Well, if I go back to my inbox, that message plus my reply is just sitting there. It's just still remaining there in my inbox, even though I no longer need it there. And maybe I could remind myself that after I hit that send key, I can come up here and archive this message. But you know what? There's a much, much simpler way. What we're going to do is actually add an additional button, a special send button, which I use 95% of the time. First off, we're going to come back to our gear icon. We are going to select See All Settings. And just below those hover actions, which we enabled in the previous step, you can see that there's an option called Send and Archive. If this is not turned on for your account, I highly recommend that you do so. Here we're going to say show the send and archive button in reply. This is only going to happen when we reply to messages. You'll see why in just a moment. And don't worry, it's still going to keep the original send button as well. Once again, I'm going to scroll down to the very bottom. I'm going to hit save changes and I'm returned to my inbox. But this time when I go to open up another email and I'm going to hit reply, you'll see that I have a secondary button. In fact, it's even more prominent. It's in the shade of blue, and it's in the left-hand position. We still have our regular send over here, but this time around, after I've added my message, I have one button to click, which is going to do two things. It's going to send the reply to that individual, but it is now no longer here within my inbox. It has automatically been sent to my all mail. It's automatically been archived as a part of the process. I use this absolutely every day with about 95% of my messages because I don't want to see that message here anymore in my inbox. I'd rather go to a label. I'd rather go to my all mail or archive location to find it if I need to in the future, in an effort to keep my inbox nice and clean. Now, I'd love to know which of these three tips did you find most helpful? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. And if you're wanting to learn even more ways to get the most out of Gmail, I recommend you watch one of these videos next. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.